our brains exploded. This was a true breakthrough moment.
We are the first people in 150 years who aren't the crazy people.
This is my secret life.
This is my secret life.
This is my secret life.
Konstantin and I met when he applied for graduate school.
I really did not expect to get in. My grades were not stellar because I was always trying to do homework either backstage or in a van.
He had worked with an astronomer at UC Santa Cruz who I greatly respect. I was like, this guy sounds like he's brilliant. I want this guy to work with me.
I actually got the acceptance email from Mike Brown. It's a common name. And then it sort of hit me, oh my God, this is the Mike Brown. And it doesn't say go away.
He just has this insight into the way things work. As far as I can tell, his insight is always right.
Our relationship is very complementary. I'm a theorist and he's an observer.
I think so concretely about the sky and he thinks so abstractly and theoretically about the universe.
A couple years ago, Mike came to my office and said, have you seen this weirdness of the outer solar system?
In the last 15 years, I have been exploring the outer part of the solar system, looking for the largest bodies out there. And we found all these objects in the Kuiper Belt.
The little Kuiper Belt objects were all swinging out into the same direction. They all lied in the same plane. It was a gravitational one-way sign towards a distant, eccentric planet in the solar system.
The first reaction from any credible astronomer when they see somebody predicting a planet in the outer solar system is always going to be, not this again, is something that's been going on for 150 years, and 150 years, it's always wrong.
You often run the risk of being called crazy.
We needed to be as certain as possible if we were gonna say it's really out there.
As a result, we spent the first year trying to disprove ourselves, testing every other possible model that could explain the data.
It was this complicated melding between computer simulations and exploration of the outer solar system. People would walk in on us and think that we were just having these heated arguments, but we were just both having a blast.
You generate a synthetic solar system on a computer and you compare that synthetic solar system to the real one. Something began to stick out. The model kept predicting these orbits that are perpendicular to the plane of the solar system, and moreover, that these orbits should be visible. We thought there could be no such orbits. I took these calculations to Mike's office. Mike said, well, I actually think I remember one such object. Let's look where it falls.
I went and looked at the catalog of all the known objects, and there were 5 objects that are indeed perpendicular to the solar system. And I looked at Konstantin, I was like, I said, if they're in these 2 locations that we're predicting, my head's gonna explode. And so I did the calculations quick, pressed the button so we could plot where they were, and
they fall exactly where the planetary model predicts them to be. I looked over at Mike and his jaw was on the floor.
It can only be explained by one large planet on this very eccentric orbit. It was a huge story. Coverage all around the world, front page of most newspapers.
This discovery captivated the public's imagination. One of the key elements of the human experience is to explore. Nature has left these puzzles for us to solve, and I want to figure them all out.